The user interface in Blender has had a massive improvement in Blender 4.3. So today, I'm going to show you the new changes and how to use them to speed up your workflow in Blender. Splitting windows is still very simple in Blender 4.3. To do this, all we need to do is come to the menu that we want to split. So let's say this 3D viewport, for example, and come to the bottom here where this arrow shape will start to appear. And then I'm just going to right click, and here I can choose my type of split. For example, I can choose a vertical split, and I can just left click it to save it like this. And this, of course, works with any menu. So I can come to the timeline here, right click, and choose a horizontal split, for example, and I've got two timelines. Moving windows is a lot more advanced in Blender 4.3, as we can now move things a lot more flexibly. For example, let's say I want to move this timeline all the way up to the top right hand corner. We wouldn't have been able to do this in previous Blender versions, but now we can in Blender 4.3. To do that, we're just going to come up to top left hand corner where we get this cross shape that's appearing. Then I can just left click and drag, and you can see here that it's going to start allowing me to move my timeline around, and I'm just going to move it to up here, and then I can just let go of left click, and now you can see my timeline has been moved up here. I recommend trying these out for yourself as we go, just to get the hang of it. We can, of course, join windows together still. The first way to do this, right click a menu we want to join. So I'll come up to this 3D viewport here, which I want to join with this one here. And I can just right click here and I can choose either join left or join right. So join right will probably join it to one of these ones here. And join left is going to move it to the one on our left here. So I'll right click again and I'm just going to choose join left. And now you can see it's been joined together again. Another way we can do that though is, like in previous Blender versions, we can still use the cross shape. So I'll come up to the top left hand corner of this outliner here, and I'm just going to wait till the cross shape appears, and I'm going to left click. And you'll notice though, when we left click and drag, it's going to do that split area feature that I was showing you earlier. But if I right click to undo that operation and left click and hold again, I can just move slowly. And you can see when I move it slowly, it's going to give us the join areas option. And if I let go of left click here, you can see those have been joined up nicely. We can also pull out some of these menus into their own separate window. What I mean by this is, for example, we could turn this properties menu here into its own window. So to do that, I can just hold down shift and then come up to where I get this cross shape appearing. And then if I left click and hold, you can see that a brand new properties Blender window has appeared, which is pretty handy, especially if you're using multiple screens. And you'll notice when I change this here, it's going to change it in here as well. So it's linked to this Blender file. I'll press X to close this window. We're also able to swap menus quite easily by holding down control, left clicking the cross here, and you can see that we can easily swap menus by just left clicking up, and now you can see those two have swapped like that. So a bunch of new cool features for navigating these menus and moving them around. The window separation one especially, by holding down shift and then left click, will be really handy for second screen users. But you could also use it to hold a reference image or something like that using the image editor, which you can just find by left clicking one of these boxes here and changing your menu to the image editor over here. So, as some of you will know, to add an image in Blender, we can come to our image editor here, and if we press this open button, it's just going to bring up my Blender file browser menu, and I'm just going to come to my downloads here, and just choose a random image. I'm just going to choose this thumbnail I made here, and just press open image. You can see that's opened up our image in Blender, just like normal, but something new has been added in 4.3, and that's if I left click this drop down here, and hover over an image, you can see that there's now an image preview, which is really handy if you forget the names of your different images, especially when baking maps or something like that, as sometimes we can forget to name our images as we should. So this can be a great way to see which image you're selecting. The last major UI change is a change to the sculpting tools in Blender. If I press add here and then under mesh, I'll just choose a cube, and then I'm going to left click object mode and change it to sculpt mode. You can see that the asset browser here has opened up, and this is how we're now going to be able to access a lot of our tools, as you can see that they've all been moved from here now, and now they're in this asset browser menu instead. So do keep that in mind when using Blender 4.3, as older Blender tutorials will have all of these tools up here instead, but they should be more or less the same. And also make sure you're on this all option if you can't find a specific tool when following an older Blender tutorial. But I reckon I'm probably going to make it an updated sculpting tutorial for Blender 4.3 because of this new change. That's not all that's been added to Blender 4.3 though, as there's also a bunch of cool new shader changes that have been added, including some new nodes, and also a brand new parameter to the all-powerful Principal BSDF shader, which I'll be covering in the next video. Thank you so much for watching, and take care.